Our next guest is one of Australian film and television's leading talents. Award-winning writer, director and producer Tony Ayres brought us, among other things, The Slap and much more recently, The Glitch.
And he's now returned to the big screen to direct a crime thriller set in the mid-1970s, 1974, I believe. Cut Snake hits the cinemas next week. Let's take a look.
Are you really going to do this?
Do you still want to?
Farrell, visitor.
Go in.
Hiya. Your own house.
This is my mate from Sydney.
Hello.
What is the surprise, mate?
You've never mentioned him before tonight.
I mean, things were a lot closer than we actually are.
I just don't want us to have any secrets.
You've done real well for yourself, young Sparra. Some of the boys have got a job on. I'm clean now. I want you gone. You can try, young Sparra. He says I owe him. From prison days.
How much do you owe him?
It's not money. He wants me to go back to the way I was.
There are many, many twists to this film and we don't want to give them away, so we're going to introduce Tony Ayres and he can decide whether he wants to spoil his own plot or not. Tony Ayres, good morning. Do you want to?
It's very tricky because I think there's a really interesting twist halfway through the film that
yes, turns, there is.
Turns it into something else.
And I would like to stay away from it because I reckon that would spoil the experience.
Yes.
So off you go.
Okay.
Tread around these landmines very carefully.
Yes,
but
okay.
I love that you set this movie in 1970s Melbourne, a part of the world that I actually grew up in, which is must explain when I looked at it, I thought, why does this look so familiar to me? It's my home territory. And a fascinating story of someone trying to reinvent themselves.
Yeah. It is a story about trying to sort of have a second chance and then...
escape your past.
The past coming back to claim you. And in a way that's surprising, you know, I think.
Very surprising.
Tell us about the actors. The three main actors here were all excellent and gave really powerful performances.
And relatively unknown, is it fair to describe them that way?
They're all sort of up and coming.
Probably
the highest profile actor is Sullivan Stapleton, who had just come off the 300 film. So, and he's now doing a huge NBC show in America.
Really? Good on him.
So he's a really wonderful actor and we've been looking for something to do together for a number of years. Jester Gouw is an up-and-coming actress who has done TV in America, and she, again, you know, I can't speak more proudly of the cast because they're really brilliant. And Alex Russell, sorry, who's actually the lead. He's the guy in the centre.
Yeah. That's right. So tell us where the story came from, about a guy who is who's caught up by his past. I think we can give away the fact that he had a time in prison, and when his ex-prison mate tracks him down and finds him, when, as we say, he's trying to put it back together. How did the story come to you?
I first read the script a long time ago at a writing prize, and I was one of the judges. And then it kind of came back to me in 2009, and I was always interested in that central triangle of characters, the guy trying to change his life, his fiancée, and the guy from the past coming back.
It's a triangle.
It is a triangle, and it's a love story. And I think that those two things really attracted to me, but it was wrapped around a classic three-act structure crime thriller.
And Tony, while we've got you here, we've got to ask you about a couple of other things, particularly Nowhere Boys.
Yes.
Tell us about Nowhere Boys and what you're doing with it now for a feature length.
Many of our viewers would be big fans and their children would be big fans of Nowhere Boys on ABC TV. So.
We're just about to release the feature film version, which kind of ties up the story of the current Nowhere Boys.
Yes.
And then we're launching into season three, which will be a whole new cast.
We just have an instinct, a strong feeling that Nowhere Boys has the possibility of being another Harry Potter in the sense that there's something universal and fabulous about this idea, this story, those great young actors, and of course the supernatural aspects to it. This could really go far, couldn't it?
I'm being very optimistic, yes.
Yes, I reckon.
What do people say about it from overseas? Have you had much reaction?
We've had a spectacular response overseas. It plays on the BBC.
And it does it?
Yeah, and season two is about to launch there any second now. And, we're big in Namibia.
Mate, I'm going to get you a T-shirt that says that. I'm big in Namibia.
I think I've got one. And,
that's hysterical.
And you know we
they know their TV in Namibia, that's for sure. Those young actors
are
just brilliant.
Yeah, aren't they?
Yeah, and I'm so proud of them because we've sort of watched them grow up from being sort of gawky teenagers to, I mean, they're all young stars now.
Yeah.
And what a great time to be working in TV and film in Australia, such wonderful productions. We mentioned Glitch and The Slap, of course. Are you just inundated with great scripts? Is the writing, the quality of writing you're getting to consider now, is it better than you've had before?
I think that we punch above our weight in Australia, absolutely. Like, we have such strong writers, directors, and of course actors who are all charting internationally.
And a quick one on Glitch. How do you think it went, being available as it was online for people to watch all at once?
Well, it went spectacularly well on iView. It was, I think, the highest rating drama on iView.
Yep.
And so we were really thrilled with how it went. And the audience response was so strong. Like, the people who responded to it loved it.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I'm so proud of it.
Yeah. A real sense of ownership over that one. Tony, so nice to meet you. Gouw well.
Thank you very much.
Tony Ayres, director there of Cutsnake. And that hits the cinemas next Thursday.